Today I'm going to go over an introduction to cropping photos in Adobe Photoshop and a couple things to consider when you're cropping. Go ahead and click on the cropping tool, open up an image, and looks like this over here, or you can press C, and it's the crop tool. And a pretty basic crop, this is if you wanted to crop out part of a photo to use in a design or print design or web design or whatnot. So if you just click and drag, if I hold shift, it'll make a perfect square, or just let go, you can make a rectangle. You let go and it automatically shades out what's going to be cropped out, just like that. And you can press enter and that will just crop it out. And that's a basic crop. Now I'm gonna hit Control Z, Command Z on Mac to undo that. Now if I go back there, do the same thing, you'll notice it has this rule of thirds here, this tic-tac-toe. That's because it's up on the top. Make sure you have the options and of course the tools palette selected. And in the options palette up here, you can see rule of thirds. You can set that to grid, or you can just hit none if you don't want any kind of grid set up there by default. Now, you can hit shield, that'll get rid of the little grayed out area around it, and you can set whatever color you want. It's just basically graying out what's not going to be in the photo once we hit enter or double click anywhere inside there. And the opacity you can adjust as well. Now perspective is a little bit different. If you notice right here, once I have a crop, I can click and drag the corner and it gets larger, smaller. I can click and drag side of the bounding box. You can set it to different sizes. Well, if I hit perspective, notice right here, it turns into a different cursor and I can bend that corner like that. And same thing down here. And then when I hit enter, it actually warps it a little bit to change the perspective just slightly. Hit Control Z to undo that. Another thing to consider is if you are designing a web page or print design and you need maybe three or four photos to be all the same size, what you can do is go up on width, let's say let's do 200 pixels. Be sure you type in px. If it does 200 inches, it'll be huge. File at resolution, I'll just do 72 pixels per inch, and then I'll click and drag it. Notice it automatically does a perfect square. And just if I did height, let's say 400, then it does a rectangle, vertically oriented, okay? Because it has to maintain that specific proportion. I hit enter, and I'm at 25%, so I'll just zoom in with Control Plus. And that's our 200 by 400 pixel right there. Then you would save it as a new JPEG. That's at 100%. Now, if you ever wanted to get rid of the settings there, you can obviously select it here. Or you could hit clear, and that would clear those presets if you just wanted to crop it without changing either the resolution or the width or height. So that's basic cropping and some considerations to think about when you're cropping. Thank you.